Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Here in this video tutorial, I am explaining you the concept of graph data structure, which is a non-linear data structure. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Let's start with a minimum spanning tree. What is minimum spanning tree, how to find out it, all these things in detail I have already explained in my previous video. Here I am taking a glance on a minimum spanning tree. So a minimum spanning tree is nothing but a spanning tree where we can find out it with the help of weighted, connected and undirected graph. And for that minimum spanning tree, weight should be minimum. So at the end, we can say that the weight of a minimum spanning tree is the smallest weight among all possible spanning trees, because we can form n number of spanning trees for the given graph. From that n number of spanning trees, the spanning tree who is having the minimum weight, that is called as minimum spanning tree. How to find out a minimum spanning tree? So first of all, we have to take the input as connected, undirected and a weighted graph. Then we have to apply an algorithm on that, and at the end you will be having the output as a minimum spanning tree. So which algorithms we have to apply to find out a minimum spanning tree? So the number of algorithms to find out a minimum spanning tree, they are two. The first one is nothing but a Kruskal's algorithm, and the second one is nothing but the Prim's algorithm. I have already explained the Kruskal's algorithm along with the solved example, animated solved example, in my previous video. For your reference, I am providing a shortcut link in this right up corner. And in this video tutorial, I am covering the concept of Prim's algorithm to find out a minimum spanning tree. So let's focus on a Prim's algorithm to find out a minimum spanning tree for a given connected, undirected and a weighted graph. So what is the basic idea behind the Prim's algorithm? So here, very first thing is we have to start with any arbitrary vertex. Let's consider any arbitrary vertex as a starting vertex, and then you have to find out all the connected edges, adjacent edges to that vertex, and with the minimum weight. Before that, let's consider first of all adjacent vertices, all adjacent edges to the vertex, the starting vertex. After that, we have to search any minimum one from the set of edges which are adjacent to the same vertex, and then you have to include that into the minimum spanning tree. And that you have to continue till you are covering all the vertices, and at the end you have to calculate the minimum weight for the minimum spanning tree. So let's start with the minimum spanning tree to find out a minimum spanning tree with Prim's algorithm and with its solved example. Here I am taking the same example which I have covered into the Kruskal's algorithm. So this is the graph we are going to consider to apply the Prim's algorithm to find out a minimum spanning tree. Let's see first of all what is Prim's algorithm. So my step number is, as I explained previously, we have to start with the any random or any arbitrary vertex that will be the starting point to find out a minimum spanning tree. After choosing any arbitrary vertex, the step number two is to find the edges that connect to the new adjacent vertex. That is, whatever we have chosen in the first step, the starting vertex, that all the connected edges, all adjacent edges, that all we have to find out, and from which we have to search only the minimum one, and that we have to add into the tree. After this, whatever the adjacent edges we have included, that all the adjacent vertices for that vertices also, we are going to find out the next adjacent vertices and edges from which we have to find out the minimum one, and that we have to include it. So this step 2 we have to continue in repetition till it includes n number of vertices. All the n number of vertices as soon as we have covered, then we will stop at this position. So let's start to apply the minimum spanning tree on the given graph. So here for your reference, I am providing you a graph over here and how we are going to apply it. So let's start with the A vertex 1 as the first vertex or a starting vertex to find out a minimum spanning tree. Which different edges are adjacent to the vertex 1? They are 1, 2 and 1, 5. From which I am choosing the one which is the minimum. So I am choosing 1, 2 edge over here. Here you can see that. After this, what are the vertices which are there? So they are 1, 2 and from that 1 and 2, let's find out all the adjacent vertices to 1. They are 1 to 5 with the age or with the weight 7, and all the adjacent vertices to 2, they are 2 to 6 with the weight 3 and 2 to 3 with the weight 8 and 2 to 5 with the weight 11. From which we have to select or choose the minimum one. So that's why I am going to choose the vertex 2 and 6 with the connected age and with weight 3. So let's include it, and after this we are having the vertices that we are going to consider to find out the adjacent edges or the vertices. They are 1, 2 and 6 with starting with 1, 1 to 5 with weight 7. For the vertex 2, the adjacent vertices are 5 with weight 11, 3 with weight 8, and for the vertex C, the adjacent vertices are 5 with weight 8, 7 with weight 2. So from these we have to choose the edge with the minimum weight. That's why I am choosing the weight 2 for the edge 6 and 7. Now we will consider 4 vertices for its adjacent edges. They are 1, 2, 6 and 7. From which, if we will go through, from which you will find out that the 7, 5 is the edge that we are going to include in a minimum spanning tree, as it is having the minimum weight among all the adjacent vertices. Now we are having 1, 2, 6, 7 and 5. These vertices of which we are going to find out the adjacent edges with the minimum weight. So here you can see that 1 and 5, if we will connect this, as it is not having the minimum weight, but if we are going to choose this one, then it is forming a cycle and which is not allowed in a minimum spanning tree. Then for 2, 2 to 5 is 11 having the highest weight, 2 to 3 is also 8. Let's go forward for the rest of the weight for the rest of the vertices, that is 6 to 5, 8, and it forms a cycle, so we are not going to include that. Now let's for the 7, for 7 it is having 7 to 3 with weight 6 and 7 to 8 with weight 2. So 7 to 8 we having the minimum weight, so that's why that we are going to include over here. Now here you can see that as we have included 1, 2, 6, 7, 5 and 8, these many vertices. So for these many vertices, we suppose to find out the adjacent vertex with the minimum weight. So now let's include the next edge is nothing but 8, 3 with the minimum weight. Now for all the included vertices, find out its adjacent vertex with the minimum weight is nothing but, now next one will be the 3, 4 with the minimum weight 7, and at the last we are having the 4, which is the vertex. For all the vertices actually we will find out the adjacent vertices which are having the minimum weight and not forming a cycle. So that's why we'll find out the next edge is nothing but 4, 9 with the minimum weight 10. And here you can find out that we have done with the including all the vertices in the minimum spanning tree, and which was our aim. And at this moment, as soon as we have done with including all the vertices, we have to stop at this position and let's calculate the minimum weight for the minimum spanning tree. It is 32. You can notice over here that the tree form from the Kruskal's algorithm and the Prim's algorithm both are same and with the weight. So that's why this is the minimum spanning tree formed by Prim's algorithm, which is not having any cycle in that, and that's why it is a tree, minimum spanning tree with the minimum weight 32. Thank you all dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment. Do share it with your friends. If you are having any query, post it in a comment box. Here I am providing you a subscription link for your reference for the channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, and the whole video series I am providing you in the form of playlist. Thank you. Stay tuned with Tech Talks. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.